Experiment 18 deals with hydrocarbons. You'll use chemical properties, that is reactions of alkanes, alkenes, and aromatics, coupled with their boiling points to identify a liquid unknown. Let's have a look at the pre-lab review sheets. There are a number of questions here. The first one, any specific safety alerts? As you read the experiment, look for those triangle icons. That'll guide you to answering that question. Number two, any specific disposal directions? Look for the garbage can icons, and that'll help you. And the rest of these are pretty straightforward. As you read the experiment, why maybe have these questions beside you, and there are none of these that are particularly hard. They're just based upon your reading and understanding of the material. Let's have a look at the data and report sheet. The first chemical reaction that you'll carry out is that with bromine. Bromine is in a solution, and it's sort of red colored. And what you'll look for you'll look for color changes. The first blank asks for your unknown ID number, and you'll get this when you enter ChemWeb. It's the student lab number. It's four digits long. And then when you carry out the reactions, for an alkane, you'll use hexane, an alkene, one hexene, and for an aromatic, you'll use toluene. And over here on the right-hand side, why record the colors that you see. In most cases, the red color of the bromine will disappear and you'll get a different color. And then you'll also test your unknown, and you'll use this information to classify your unknown. Not at this point, but when you've done several parts of the experiment. Losing my voice there. So in other words, if an alkene, one hexene, gives a particular color when you react it with bromine, and your unknown does exactly the same thing, well, that's an indication that your unknown is an alkene. Part B looks at the reaction with potassium permanganate. And again, you'll look for color changes. And alkanes, alkenes, and aromatics give characteristic reactions with potassium permanganate. And you'll try and correlate the color of your unknown with one of those three. In part C, you'll be looking at the flammability of hydrocarbons. And each of these substances, as hydrocarbons, will burn, and they'll give off various amounts of smoke or soot. And so some of the terms that you'll maybe use in describing what you see in the photographs would be none, or some, or lots. That would be fine. Not real specific, but yet indicate the amount of smoke that you see. And then table 18.4 is a summary now of all the results so far, the reaction with bromine, the reaction with potassium permanganate, and the flammability test. And you'll come back to this table and correlate so that you can identify your unknown as either an alkane, alkene, or an aromatic. And the other thing that you'll do in this experiment is a boiling point determination. And here are these three substances on the left, and using the photographs, you'll be able to decipher their measured boiling points. And those measured boiling points are going to be different than the normal boiling point or the literature. The word normal means at sea level, and in some cases, you're not at sea level, but up in the mountains. And so your values may differ from the literature values. And there's a difference in the sensitivity of the thermometers too. Over on the right-hand side is a classification now of your unknown. What did the bromine test indicate? Is your unknown an alkane, alkene, or an aromatic? The same with potassium permanganate, and the same with flammability. So after you conclude this table 18.6, you should really have an idea of which of those three classes your unknown is in. Table 18.7 gets down to the identification of the unknown now. The first blank is the ID number, so repeat that. The unknown normal boiling point, and I'll come down to the graph here in a second and show you how you get that. This third line is where you identify your unknown as an alkane, alkene, or an aromatic. And the fourth line is where you pick out a specific compound using the normal boiling point. In the calculations and report page in the text, there are three columns of compounds, a column of alkanes, a column of alkenes, and a column of aromatics. So if, for example, you identify your unknown as an alkene, then you'll use the boiling point to say which alkene it is. Down here's the graph now. You'll not only make this graph, but then you'll use the graph. When you obtain the measured boiling points of three compounds, you'll plot that information here. If you need a little bit of review on graphing, go to Appendix A. Let's just look at the first compound. Its normal boiling point is near 69 degrees centigrade. And so I come up with a hypothetical line from 69, and the measured boiling point was a little less than that, and I come across from that value, the measured boiling point that you obtained from the photograph, and where those two lines intersect, we'll make a point. We'll do that for the second compound and the third compound to get 3 points, and then we'll draw a straight line between connecting those or best fitting those 3 points. And then when you have your unknown and you want to get the unknown's normal boiling point, you'll use the graph. And here's how you would use it. You'll get the measured boiling point of your unknown. You'll come across whatever that value is till you hit the line and then come down, and that would give you the normal boiling point. So again, identifying your unknown is a critical part of the experiment. Be sure that you've identified it correctly as far as its classification. And then just look within that column, whichever one of these three you think it is, and pick out the boiling point that comes closest to one of those values. Then we're to the questions at the end of the experiment. I think there are just four of these. None of them are particularly hard. They're based upon the chemical reactions that you carry out. I think you'll be in fine shape. So if you have any questions or comments, you can call me at any time or email me. I'll be happy to help.